So welcome to our Healthy Living series on Medicare Annual Wellness Visits. Our first presenter, or one of our presenters, is Dr. Matthew Bihlmeier, and his medical degree is from Kansas City University of Medicine and Biosciences in Kansas City, Missouri. He completed his residency at the University of Missouri, Kansas City, in internal medicine. He completed a geriatric fellowship at Truman Lake Hospital in Lee Summit, Missouri, and he is board certified in internal medicine. Malwina Zastawna is our population health manager, and she has a Bachelor of Science from the University of Idaho and a Master of Science Administration from the University of Kansas. She is a registered nurse and is certified as a Lean Six Sigma Green Belt. And Stacey Laughrey, also with our Population Health Department, she's our Population Health Lead. She has an associate's degree from the University of Louisiana, Bachelor of Science from the University of Arizona. She is also a registered nurse, a certified case manager, and a certified clinical health coach. So we have a lot of expertise here this evening. So please, please feel free to ask those questions and learn all that you can. So with that, I am going to go ahead and turn it to Malwina.
Thank you so much, Allison, and good evening, everyone. I am really delighted to be here and share with you some information about something that I'm really passionate about, share information about this great benefit available to Medicare patients. First, I would like to talk about our objectives for tonight, what it is that we would like to accomplish by the end of this presentation. First, we would like to provide you with some background and justification as to why annual wellness visits were even created in the first place. Next, we will speak to benefits of annual wellness visits and explain the importance of scheduling one, or talk more about what kind of benefits having a visit, a Medicare annual wellness visit, might bring. And lastly, we will describe what you can expect. What is it that the next steps might be, as well as what it is that you might expect to happen during an actual annual wellness visit. So we will take a little bit of a deeper dive into those elements that are a part of a wellness visit. Next slide, please. So we will talk about the why first. We have the presentation structured, so we're talking about the why and the what and the how. So though, starting with the why, and we can go to the next slide. So authorities, healthcare agencies have developed a guiding principle that you might have heard of that is called triple aim. And that triple aim has three different elements that we want to focus on in care delivery. One is better care for patients, also better experience for patients, as well as lower cost to make Medicare sustainable. Annual wellness visits really help to meet this goal called triple aim because they are based on an idea that we dedicate time and space to meeting with each patient to go over all their health needs, which hopefully then in turn leads to better care and better experience for patients, as well as lower costs, because hopefully we're helping to prevent events such as hospitalizations and visits to the ER, which can be pretty costly. Preventive care is a guiding principle behind annual wellness visits. It is a really important step that one can take to help manage at one's health. And I say that because many of the top risk factors that lead to illness and premature death are often preventable. And I do have a quote here on the slide. It is by Benjamin Franklin, that an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. And that really resonates with me, because you may not be able to control everything, not control every medical condition fully, but following those preventive care guidelines actually might reduce your chances of serious illness or make your symptoms a little less severe. You can go to the next slide. Thank you. This is just a little bit more about the why behind the creation of this service. So let's start with a little bit of history. The healthcare system is really in an almost constant state of reinvention. And the Medicare system that is in place today is not exactly the same that it was back in 1965 when it was first created. When President Johnson enacted legislation that introduced Medicare and Medicaid into law, the life expectancy was about 70 years old. Now people live to be about, and then again, it's average, 80 years old. So the life expectancy has, it's about a decade longer now. Also, people in general tend to have more chronic conditions than they did a couple decades ago. And because Medicare was designed as a safety net for people with acute conditions, with immediate concerns, and the population has changed, Medicare has also had to adapt to those evolving needs of our patients. And one of the responses that Medicare has brought as a result of that is many new services. We call them many new service codes that emphasize wellness, that emphasize prevention and annual wellness visits. That's one of those codes or services that is now available to patients. It's a benefit that Medicare has made a large investment into. And I'll stop here and I'll see just to check if Dr. Bihlmeier, Stacey, do you have anything to add?
Well, first I just wanna say again, thank you for setting this up, and the annual wellness visit is integral to a patient's overall health. And as I'm sure we'll get to certain things that we can address during that visit in hopes of keeping them well for the at least the next year, if not the foreseeable future, and identifying any certain risk factors that they may not have realized otherwise. And so yes, I agree. The annual wellness visit is integral to their health.
And I think I'll just jump in here on our next slide. Kind of it goes into more of why the preventative health focus is so important. And it's not necessarily an easy task. There's a lot of different recommendations based on an individual's age and gender and medical history, family history. So trying to kind of wade through all the recommendations that you may hear from time to time about, you know, what age should you get that and how often should this happen, can be really challenging. But the benefit of the annual wellness visit really is that you have someone that can sit down with you and look through your records, and all your history and recommendations can then be determined based on that. So you get a really individualized plan. A lot of these screenings are very beneficial because they help people stay healthy, as Dr. Bihlmeier referenced, and help us in the early stages of identification. So we're not trying to play catch up with a condition that's already kind of been lingering that we were not aware of. So these screening tools can be really crucial in that early stages and really make sure we get you the care that you need early on for treatment. Let's go to the next slide, please. So the way we work with the annual wellness visit to develop your preventative plan is, like I said, we'll sit down and really look, dive into that history, and we develop an actual written plan that we send home with you and share with your provider to make sure that they're aware of all the recommendations that you've been made aware of and all the considerations or questions or concerns that you had. We'll also look at any potential services that might be available that could be a benefit to you, whether it's a physical therapy recommendation or a social work recommendation or if you need assistance with transportation or any kind of services in the community, outside of the general health care things, just other issues that you may be struggling with at home, things that we're aware of that we can make recommendations and referrals for you. And then again, that preventative plan, you'll have a kind of a game plan, like I said, for the next year of things that are coming due, what the plan is for how those will get ordered. And you'll be able to come in and sit down with your provider and discuss their specific recommendations based on that kind of initial screening tool there. So let's go on to the next one, I think. Okay, so how we put this all together, like I said, it is a bit complicated, and that putting that plan together does take a team effort. So I'm going to now go into who is a part of that team. If you can go on to the next slide for us. So we have nurses in the clinics that work directly with the providers. They are trained specifically to help facilitate these annual wellness visits because it is such a specialist type of visit. The visits are scheduled for about 45 to 60 minutes, kind of depending on the clinic and the provider preferences there. It is exclusively delivered by the nurse in many situations, but there occasionally will be a brief encounter with the provider at the end, and that's provider preference. Otherwise, we will probably have you schedule a follow-up visit with your provider in a couple weeks to review the results from your nurse visit. And the visit, like I said, in all takes about 45 to 60 minutes. They're gonna sit down with you, go through all that information, put together that preventative plan with you. All the information goes into your medical record and is shared with your provider so they can look over everything. They will oftentimes take that information and discuss it with you at your follow-up, whether it's that same day or a few weeks out, and may have some recommendations for other screenings and tests based on your history and their relationship with you that they might recommend. So that is a part of how we do the team effort. There's also instances where we will involve our outpatient pharmacist or outpatient social worker who can come in again with those community resources or medication questions because that is their specialty. They're highly skilled and able to help address some of those concerns. So we definitely look at it as a team effort. We'll often make recommendations for diabetic education or different resources like that that might be a benefit to you as well. So it really is a team effort, all kind of coordinated by your provider, and the nurse helps facilitate that during that kind of extended visit where you get to sit down and say, hey, this is what's really going on with me. This is what I really want to focus on for the next year. Next slide. Hand this back off to Malwina, I believe.
So Stacey talked about that a little bit already. I would like to talk about the how as well. So what to expect during the visit as well as possible next steps. First though, I would like to emphasize that this visit that was, I don't think we mentioned that it was created in 2011. So believe it or not, it's already been a decade. The visit is free. The visit itself is free. However, something to keep in mind is that if there's anything extra included on top of the visit itself, like lab work or any diagnostic testing or anything that might be a result of might need to happen as a result of different screenings, if they're positive and if they indicate further diagnostic work, for example, then or medication management, or if they lead to subsequent visits with the provider, those services will be charged and covered according to Medicare's usual coverage guidelines. So I just wanted to provide this caveat, but the visit itself is free of charge. There is no out-of-pocket expense, no deductible or co-insurance. So that's pretty nice. That just indicates to me that Medicare has really made this into an investment that they really think is important. As Stacey said, the visit itself is performed by a nurse coming from population health team. We refer to them as population health nurses. And they are highly qualified and trained individuals who really work very closely with providers. The provider is still very much a quarterback of the team. And healthcare is a team sport. So provider still is very much involved, but you might not see the provider during that visit. However, you might see your provider shortly after the visit, if that's necessary. One of the benefits, and I'm sure Dr. Bihlmeier will have something to add here. One of the benefits is that the data that we gather from patients during an annual wellness visit really helps to provide this big picture, comprehensive picture of the patient to providers, which then in turn might help providers create and adjust treatment plans, make appropriate referrals and treatment decisions. So this is really one of the big benefits of the visit. It really provides us time and space for you as a patient and for us as a healthcare team to discuss those short and long-term steps to catch health issues that might be potentially serious, to catch them early, to improve your health, and to stay well so you can continue to do things that you love. And as Stacey mentioned, following this visit, we will establish a screening or written screening schedule and plan of care to keep track of your healthcare needs and to stay focused on your health. And we will ask a lot of questions during the visit. But it's not because we're trying to be nosy in any way. Any information that we ask about either your daily routine or family medical history or personal medical history, it's all to help us provide you as a patient with the best care possible. So I'll stop here. Dr. Bihlmeier, do you have anything to add here?
A couple of things. I think the biggest benefit from a provider point of view of the wellness nurse doing these screenings, as you mentioned, they can take upward to 45 minutes to an hour, and that's just on prevention alone. And so that is time that your provider does not need to spend at your next appointment going over all these details, because they are nicely outlined by the wellness nurse, and more focus can be put on more acute issues, unless, of course, something is brought up at the wellness meeting that the nurse believes need further management. But it really does let us, the provider, turn our focus onto your acute medical care at that next visit.
We can go to the next slide, Allison. Thank you. In terms of next steps, we would love to see you. We would love to see as many of our patients as possible for the annual wellness visit. We do see a lot of patients already, but we are happy to see more. And I hope that we have been able to convince some patients today or of the value of the visit, or at least raise awareness that this benefit exists and is available to you as a Medicare beneficiary. We do scan our patient panel or patient population for annual wellness visit eligibility. What that means, what I mean by scanning is there's a portal that Medicare provides to us as a healthcare organization that indicates whether or not you as a patient has had an annual wellness visit. Also, we have, of course, our electronic medical records that might contain similar information. So we do check our patients for eligibility for the annual wellness visit. And if we discover that someone is eligible and is due for an annual wellness visit, we usually call them. We perform active outreach to our patients to let them know about this benefit and invite them to schedule a visit. And this is something that might happen to anyone that might be with us tonight or watching. Might hear from us. So I am saying that so nobody will be surprised if they do receive a call from the population health team inviting them to schedule an annual wellness visit if they would like. You can of course call us yourself and schedule a wellness visit if that's something you're interested in. And one thing that I'll just mention is that once you have that schedule, then are getting ready to come in. Those visits are also available via telehealth. So if you do not want to come in person, that option is available to do it a video conference essentially with your care team. We ask that you please bring a list of one, all your providers, so your doctors, any healthcare professionals you might be seeing, like maybe chiropractors or physical therapists, perhaps, as well as a list of your medications that will help us in establishing appropriate guidelines and again, providing the best care possible if we have that information. So we would love to see you at the annual wellness visit, and thank you so much for your attention.